Hey, everybody, it's Case, and you're hanging out with me on a Wednesday. Last Wednesday of the month. I have no idea where 2018 is going, but my God, it's just flying by. And of course, we're hanging out with the Wall to Wall Country Show, and it's all about country here. And each and every week, I'm excited to either have a classic artist or a new artist or somebody in between that has something to do with the country music industry. And I'm so glad I could get these guys together because I know they travel a lot and they're bouncing all over literally the world. But so excited to have these guys on board today. Very honored and pleased. Two established artists in their own right. You're going to know who they are when you hear about their background just a little bit. People in the know that. Some people don't know who they are and they think they're new to the music industry, but they're really, really not. We're going to touch base on some of their personal independent success and then about something that is just hot on the country music charts right now. Please make welcome to the show, Kaci Brown and Sam Gray, better known as Brown and Gray. Hey guys, how you doing?
Hey, how you doing?
I have ever heard, Kaci, you're not going to work on the air anymore. You're coming on the road with us.
Okay. Oh, no, wait.
Just do this show remotely. You're going to do this show remotely from everywhere with us.
All right. Okay. Here. No, wait. Let me think about that for a second. Twist my arm. Well, okay. If you really need me.
With an intro like that, we need you.
Aw, you guys are sweet.
I'm not afraid to say it.
Aw. Boxing match.
So, you know, I have to say, first off, I was trying to dig, but I was really having a hard time.
Don't dig.
I'm just going to ask, okay? So, first off, you guys do have two very different backgrounds, very independent successes. I mean, that wasn't just, you know, the intro. That's a fact with you guys. So, let's go with ladies first. Kaci, you have a very, very interesting background with how young you got started and some of the success you've already had. But if you can give us a little background information about Kaci Brown, where she came from and how she got to this combination of brown and gray, that'd be awesome.
How long do you have? Stories like my granddad tells stories and we'll be here for the next decade. I come from a really small town in Texas. My mom says that she knew that that I was born for this when I was running around in a diaper with a wooden spoon at two or less than two singing I've Got Friends in Low Places with by Garth Brooks. And there was a local talent show that she put me in. By 2.5 or 3, I was up there. She and my grandma have video of it. Super cute, actually. But I'm tapping my little foot in my cowboy boot. I've got a hat on. I've got the big belt. My mom at the time, I think, owned a Western wear store called Bauman's Jeans in our local hometown in Texas. So I'm born country, but then my path took me to Nashville at around 11, 12. I ended up moving and signing a publishing and artist developmental deal. Made a country album that never came out, but it got the experience that, you know, I don't know anyone else that really has this story, to be able to work with writers like Tommy Lee James and Sonny LeMaire and Clay Mills and just be, I don't know, like seasoned from an early age and taught from an early age how to write country music. I ended up working with a pop German producer by the name of Toby Gad and making a pop album that did come out on Interscope when I was 16 and toured with the Backstreet Boys. There were in-house disagreements as to what direction to go with the second record, and I also got into a car accident and broke my foot and didn't walk for a year. So many things happened, and that album, the sophomore album on Interscope, never came out. It's 11-11, guys. Make a wish! So, yeah. Then I met Kenneth Komisar along the way, and Ken, a few years back, reached out to me. We reconnected. And he was telling me some exciting things were happening over at Notting Hill. And one of those exciting things that were happening was Sam Gray. And
God, man.
So Ken was kind of the conduit that connected my past to Notting Hill and Sam. And Top Down was what brought Sam and I together.
Awesome. Awesome. So that was the connection I couldn't figure out. I couldn't figure out how you two got together, considering your backgrounds are incredibly different. A Texas girl meeting a guy from the UK and coming out with this awesome song, it just blew my mind. So now we know a little bit about Kaci and how she literally from all but birth got into this industry and really held her own, you know, in the genre of pop and with the Backstreet Boys and all that kind of stuff. Now, Sam, your background's a little bit different. Why don't you give us a little quick synopsis of how you got to where you are with Brown and Gray?
All right. Well, hello, everybody. It's amazing to be on the show. Thank you very much for having us on here. I'm basically similar way, but like English, I suppose. I grew up in a humble town in Yorkshire, and I got into music. I firstly got into music. I was singing opera music in my pram in the local butchers. And just like, you know, like blasting out music. And my mum was like, oh, I think he's going to be a singer, you know. And I got into playing the violin at an early age. So I was like classically trained from an early age. I was playing school concerts and stuff. And basically didn't get into playing, writing songs until I was about 14 because I knew that's kind of what the girls liked. So I was just trying to impress the ladies, basically. But I loved it, so I just kept on going with it and never really kind of considered it as a career until I figured out that I could do it as a course at university, and I went and studied songwriting in Manchester, in England, and just carried on writing the music, playing the violin, and then made an album, basically. So I was kind of working in a bar after I graduated. Thought, you know, I really want to kind of make music and just take it to London and see if anyone's interested in signing me up. And then I met a really cool guy that played drums for a big band called Paul Weller, and he picked up my music, and he showed it to my publishing company now in London, and took it down there and showed it to Andy McQueen, who's my manager currently. And he loved the music. He took me to the pub and got me drunk on Stella Artois. basically just signed me up for a pretty cheap. That's how I got into writing music for a publishing company. And then obviously that publishing company, they released a couple of albums with me, kind of like Ed Sheeran style. And I've been doing a bunch of songwriting for like DJ stuff on that publishing company for a few years. And then, Top Down happened at a writing camp. I was writing some music at a writing camp they set up. And that's how I met Kaci, basically. I wrote the song in London, and it just needed something extra on the record. And Andy told me about Kaci. He said, I've got this beautiful, beautiful, amazingly talented singer from Texas that I think would just make the record, you know. And I flew over to LA, and we recorded the tune, and that's how we kind of got together. So
that's awesome.
It happened very organically.
Yeah. That's kind of cool. So, Kaci, when you met Sam and you heard the song, or you know, it was presented to you, did you realize it was going to be like, you know, this really cool summertime fun feeling song, or did you think, like, you know, where were your thoughts on this?
Well, I heard Sam on it. Sam can sing anything and sound like butter. He's amazing. Like, he doesn't even have to sing a word. I'm like, yeah, that's it. What is it? I don't know. We'll just say something that sounds like that. And it works. He's amazing. So I heard the song. I knew it was going to be a summertime fun thing. But what I didn't know is it was going to be released by us, or we were a thing, or it would turn into what it has turned into and what it's continuing to turn into. What I thought, you know, this is a great company that's constantly having success with syncs and whatnot. So I didn't know exactly what I was recording it for, other than let's record it. So I had on a hat, he had on a hat, you know, nobody was really like getting to know each other. We just were going in and doing what we do every day. We were just working and creating and see what happens with it. You know, so then the next time around that I met Sam, we're like, we sounded really good on that record together. I wonder what's going to happen with it. We were in a writing session. Again, still in hats, where we both showed up, you know, casual in the studio. Nobody's really looking at anybody. Then, like, a few months progressed, and we were getting mixes back from the other things that we wrote together and all of this stuff. I'm like, man, we really sound good together, and I really love working with him. And then we get this Notting Hill's like, hey, yo, we're gonna release this. Let's shoot a music video. I'm like, I'm down. Is he down? He's down. What should we call ourselves? I don't know. We both have names, Brown and Gray. They send over a one sheet because we obviously hadn't taken any pictures together yet. They send over a one sheet with Sam, and I'm like, I called Sam. I'm like, Ken, He's so much cuter than I thought he was. I don't think I've ever seen his face. We're both in hats. I have no idea. Look at those eyes. And
it's
so
to get moisturized, you know.
Oh my gosh.
Give me a glove.
Amazing.
So, okay, so the big question is, are you a couple, or are you guys just really, really...
We're a couple of dorks.
Aww.
We're a couple of weirdos.
Aww.
We have this alternative life to what we are.
Okay.
We kind of just pretend to fool around, and we work, man, because we've got strange humor, both of us, so...
That's awesome.
We just...
So the the chemistry's there as a good, you know, working, and also, you know, obviously you guys are friends, you're becoming good friends, and moving forward with that. Is there a future for Brown and Gray? Are you guys planning on, you know, actually doing this whole band thing together and releasing more music and an album and all this other kind of stuff?
Definitely.
The future. It's the present and the future, for sure.
Okay.
Yeah, for sure.
That's, you know. Well, that's great, because I think your fans are hooked, and they're going to want more.
Cool.
I really do. This is an amazing song. The video's great. I love the Mustang. Whose Mustang is that?
I wish it were mine. I wish I could. I tried to drive off with it.
Crazy lady shoulder, yeah.
On the canyon while we were shooting a couple times. It was, like, stalling.
Oh, now we're trying to film you. She's like, no, I'm going. See you later. I'm going.
I love Mustangs. I have a Mustang of my own, so I was like, oh, that's a great car. That's a beautiful car.
That's exactly what I wanted in high school. I wanted a Mustang in high school. I was like, I want a Mustang. All the cool kids had the Mustangs.
Yep. That was the same problem with me. I wanted a Mustang. I took my dad to a couple of used cars. I was like, look, there's a Mustang, Dad. And he'd always find something wrong with it. Oh, there's this wrong with it and that wrong. And I finally... like, you know, had a crisis, an age crisis at the age of 50 and bought my own damn Mustang. I was like, there you go, Dad. I bought my own Mustang. I don't need your permission.
Yes, woman. Yes.
So I bought a...
love it. What color?
I bought a 72 Mach 1, original Mach 1, and it's the gold flake color. It's the Mach 1, though.
Can we use this for the next video?
Absolutely. As long as I can drive it there and be a part of the fun, absolutely. I would love my car in a video. It's a beautiful car.
Over here.
I will. I'll send a picture. I'll send a picture to Aaron, so you guys can see.
Oh, wow.
It.
Oh, man, I can't wait. Cool.
Anyway, so excited about this music. The video is awesome. I mean, the whole time I think people are smiling and just enjoying the sunshine that you guys are there with and that. Now, are you guys getting out to able to perform this thing together? I see on the website there's a couple of tour dates. Are you actually doing a tour? Is this going to turn into something bigger?
Yeah, well, we just signed up to an amazing agency that are getting the dates as we speak.
Okay.
We want to take this with. We want to take it everywhere. You know, we want to travel the U.S. and just travel the world and just take it to as many people who want to listen to us. You know.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Yeah. We really want to do it, you know. We're in for the long haul, definitely.
So, Kaci, do you feel like this is where you should have been when your other country album didn't quite get there? Is this like finally you're feeling like you finally are where you're supposed to be?
Oh, absolutely. I mean, this is gold. This is like what you can't accomplish. What wouldn't have even been believable, or the content material that I wouldn't have been able to write because I didn't have the experiences. It's not even, you know, lack of talent. So I can't say it's where I should have been because it's unrealistic. Mm-hmm. If I could have been here then I would have been. But it took all of it to get here, and what Sam and I have collectively is better than I could have imagined trying to do on my own as a youngster, you know. Or even now, because it's so much fun. It's a gift to be able to collaborate and really just have the give and take of a creative relationship. And being able to be up on the stage and, like, every now and then be like, what the heck is that word? And you look over and you can remember because, like, someone else is there. And I've never had the luxury of being able to, like, bounce off of anyone. And so it's kind of even more fun than being solo, to be honest with you.
Sam, are you feeling the same way?
Oh, yeah, definitely. It's just, I mean, we're both in the solo thing, and it's kind of, you know, it's great playing that way, but the banter and the jokes we have on stage, I think, just added a lot to it.
Well, we're just ridiculous.
We're goofy, you know, like, we're, yeah, exactly. It's almost like a comedy show and a musical.
Like, I wish, Casey, I wish you could have seen our live feed, because we don't do a lot of it individually, but when we're together, it's hysterical. And we got Penn sleeping on the airplane, and we were, like, picking his nose and, like, playing with his ear, and he ended up throwing a water bottle at him, and we were Instagramming it the whole time, cracking up. His kids got to see him getting,
tormented. Tormented is the word.
Amazing. It's so fun, though.
Toothpaste with me. I was going to give him a little toothpaste mustache, but I never had that with me.
Well, toothpaste is so much nicer than Sharpie. You're sweet. Toothpaste is like, you did him a favor.
Okay, rationalize the torment. That's even better. I like it.
So, take it. It's a big boy.
You guys are awesome. You're so sweet. And one I want you to know is, you know, you are getting out there. When you get out there, please consider coming to Northeast Pennsylvania. I mean, we'd love to see you here in the studios, and
sure,
I think it would be a lot of fun. So I want to make sure I throw that invitation out there. Know that you're always welcome here. We have a nice living room setting. You guys can bring your guitars, and it just would be a lot of fun to have you live in the studios.
Oh, we'd love to come play. You would love. Let's work it out. We'll work that out.
I would love that too.
And a ride in the Mustang, yeah?
Yeah, I'll bring the Mustang up. There you go.
Oh, yeah.
There are the conditions. Feed us and take us for a ride.
I can do both. I can do both easily.
Yes.
It's got the original motor in it. It's a standard. It's three on the floor, and it's a, you know, it's just a really pretty car. But,
Oh, you're a hot car. You guys are standard. She knows how to work the stick. Good
yeah.
for you.
I got a standard Jeep Rubicon, and all of our vehicles are standard. I grew up on standard, and I know standard isn't standard. Standard is now automatic, but when I grew up, standard was standard.
Well, standard is still standard in Texas in many ways, but not in California because you roll on the hills.
It's, yeah.
I was trying to impress a boy. I was like, yeah, I'm from Texas. I was like 17, new to Cali. I was like flirting with this guy from work because I worked at Abercrombie part-time for a minute, and I was like trying to impress him, and the car totally stalled out. Totally stalled out on a hill, and I was like, I am never driving a standard in California again.
Jimmy, like you did in the video.
But that one was automatic. That was just, I don't know what was wrong.
You stalled an automatic? How did you stall an automatic?
I don't know, but I did.
Oh my God, you guys are too fun. Too fun. But let's try to get back around to the music for just a second. So listen, I need to take a break, and I hate to do that, but I do need to take. Can you guys hang in there for just a minute?
Yeah, man. Get yourself quick.
We're hanging.
Okay.
We're here for you.
That's awesome, because right. What I want to do is I need to take a break and pay some bills, but I want to come back with that song that is just burning up the charts. People love it. I mean, it's just one of those songs that everybody's just going to have to sing along with, and if you haven't heard it yet, I got to say, this thing is really going to get out there. But it's called Top Down, and it's a lot of fun. If you get the chance, you got to watch the video. You can find the video on YouTube. Currently, you can find them independently, Kaci Brown and Sam Gray. But there is a website out there to find them both. And I'm going to assume that thing is going to get bigger and start incorporating some other things as you guys are going, yes?
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, well, that's the plan. Rev it up.
All
and
right.
Look at you. This is why we need you. We need you to go tell everybody how great this is. This is amazing.
This is, well, I love it. I love it. So I'm going to have to put you guys on hold for just a second, but we're going to be back more with Kaci and Sam, better known right now as Brown and Gray, and we're going to have that single that they have out there that is just freaking amazing. Put a smile on your face because it's going to be stuck there for a while. Top Down is coming up right after the break. Woo! Right here. Don't forget, go look for that video too, because you got to see that car, man. If you're an older car lover or a Mustang lover, it's a beautiful car. But we'll be back with these guys.
You can't get rid of it.
I know, this is crazy. I gotta take a break. We'll be back in just a minute with Brown and Gray and their song "Come Top Down" in just a minute. And there you heard it, the song. I love it. A little something called Top Down. And I know it's January, but it just makes me want summertime to come back in those warm temperatures where you're hanging out on the beach, driving with your cars top down. I got a Jeep Rubicon too. I love it when I can drive with the top down and go topless. Oops, did I say that out loud?
All the top down, man.
That's the X-rated version of the music video is going to star the other Kaci.
Hey, now.
I go pants down all the way.
but hey, I want a percentage of that because I'm sure you're going to bank on it.
Yeah, well, let's
We need to work out this agreement over jacket.
I know. When we're off the air, girl, when we're off the air, we'll talk afterwards. But what a great song, the inspiration of it. Now, let me ask you this. When you guys were doing it and kind of thinking about it, now, the way it was done, was that the idea when you first kind of got it started, or was it one of those things where you were thinking, oh, we're just going to do this song, but you had no idea how it was going to get blown out of the water with that video?
Casey, you want to answer? Are you there?
Hello? Yeah.
I'm here. I'm slipping into my American accent because we've got a friend with us at the minute writing music called Brad Chrysler.
Okay.
He's from Alabama, and I keep on trying to do his accent. It's like the four people on the interviews. It's like me from Yorkshire, me from Alabama, and you guys. So I apologize if there's two guys here. No, it's just one. We just wrote the song. We just wanted to write a fun song, you know, like, but like, when I sang, and I got my top down driving, that was kind of one of the first things I got on the song, you know?
Okay, stop. We got to stop. Huh? I have to say, how do you guys, with accents, do it? You talk, you have an accent, you can tell, you know, you have that British background, and then you sing, and it's gone. Like, it's listening to you sing wouldn't even...
No, except for when it's not... When we were recording the Christmas song, go listen to the Christmas song,
okay,
for example. He said, what is the word you say? It's the word is come, and it's like...
Oh, come I don't, on, what
do you say? Anyway, he says comb around. He's like comb. It's like almost like comb, like COMB, like I'm combing my hair. And I'm like, it's come around.
Sing all my answers to questions, you know. I just sing the answer to my questions all the time.
I just think it's funny. On
we have, on, have another song called Better, and he sings butter.
Oh,
butter,
okay.
Butter.
All right. Okay. It's just interesting on the whole song. I listened to the top down song and I'm not catching it. So, you know, might be other words, certain words here and there. And you hang out with him, Casey, so you probably catch it maybe a little bit more. But I had no idea he was from London until I started reading about this guy. And I was like, holy crap, he doesn't sound like he's from British at all. He sounds completely American when he sings that song. I was like, really?
It just goes back to Sam being a great vocalist. I mean, you have people like Keith Urban also that they have accents when they speak,
yeah,
but they still sound, you know, country. But you do catch words just every now and then. And it, yeah. But I like it. I like it. It's charming. It's like Sam is a country fan, and he sounds country, sounds great, but he's also not throwing it on or trying to make it sound twangy to be something that he's not,
right,
either.
Right.
You know?
That's awesome.
This is amazing. If you just keep on complimenting me, I'm just going to sit and listen. This is incredible.
Well, that is, you guys definitely, I mean, even over the phone, I can tell you guys have some great chemistry going on there. And obviously, you know, I'm looking forward to anything that you guys put out there as a duo, as a team, as a couple, or whatever you want to call, you know, your collaboration here. And I think it's going to be awesome. And I really think you're going to be, you know, one of the next best couples in the country music industry. And I know I have other artists who call me from Sweden and Europe and UK and Canada and all over the place. So the world's it's not that small anymore, especially with the electronic medias and all that. Oh, and speaking of that, you had said something to me that you guys were over in London just recently, right?
Yeah.
Yes. We flew
out
on
the airplane.
16th and back on the 24th and had a show on the 18th. Awesome.
So,
awesome. I didn't want to leave, though.
Now, it's pretty big over there, Sam. Country's pretty big over there in the UK, so the audiences had to be eating you guys up, man.
It was amazing. Like, we played at a place called Coco in London, which is a really kind of like prestigious venue, and the crowd would just go mental. It was great. I think the main thing is just, you know, great songs.
Yeah.
You know, like, if you write a good song, it's universal.
Right.
You know what I mean? Like, and there's definitely a huge country scene in England, you know, with the Shires, and Shania Twain was huge, and,
yeah,
and Johnny Cash. You know what I mean? Everyone just loves great music and great songs, and there's definitely a market for and a huge fan base. So we're going to go back a bunch of times and do loads of shows and stuff. But we're going to come to you first and do a show.
That's right. And ride in my car.
Exactly.
Well, I think that's awesome. I think what you guys are doing, like I said, I think you are just you're just really, really just at the tip of this thing. And I think it's going to get insane. Now, how can people find you guys? Because I know you're still working on, you know, growing this whole idea. Right. Tell me how your fans can find you and figure out where you're going to be. Are you guys on the social medias and all that kind of stuff? Tell me how to find you.
Got a list in front of me that my manager's holding up. So I've got to read it out. Okay, so on Facebook and Instagram, you can find us on the Brown and Gray Music.
Okay.
Someone leave comments and, you know, look at the Mustang and stuff. And on Twitter, you can find us at Brown and Gray. So it's Brown without an O. So it's B-R-W-N and Gray.
Okay.
Yeah. Did I get that right? Did I waffle?
What's a waffle?
Right. I think that's right. I still get confused about the handle that doesn't have it all there. Okay. But we both have access to all of the accounts and the messaging for, like, the YouTube and the Facebook page, the Twitter, and the Instagram.
Okay.
So if you reach out, somebody, if it's not one of us, somebody from the team will see it, and we have access to get in and respond. So, we're working it.
Awesome.
Collectively.
All right. And people can find you also on, you said, like, the YouTube channel and stuff. And there's also a brownandgraymusic.com where they can also see the video and find you on iTunes, Spotify, the electronic medias if they want to get their hands on that song, Top Down.
Yeah.
All of it.
Spotify, anywhere they want, you know.
Okay.
Our goal is find us at the meet and greet.
Okay.
Stalk us on all of those platforms to find out where we're playing and come see us in person /, let's shake hands and say hello. We want to be out performing and actually, like, engaging in real life, because we're really bad. Like, we're getting better and we're being taught how to be better about this online engagement, but, like, we really want to meet our fans. Yeah. We really want to be there and perform. So you're asking us to come there. We're like, absolutely, let's make it happen. Like, that's what we want to do.
That's great. And that's something that I think sometimes artists forget or kind of get too busy and don't do. So I hope you guys keep that to heart as, you know, you guys are growing and more fans and the popular and the more music and all that kind of stuff. That's something that, you know, you guys are already veteran artists. You know that.
We love it. We love it when we get a video in that someone's driving the car and they've got the Top Down, the song's playing, you know, and that's what we love. We want to hear from people who are loving the tunes, and we want to make more music for people that just love the music, you know. Mm-hmm. So, for me, as a coming chapter, we're open to it. We're accessible, baby.
All right. That's awesome. And I hope you stay that way. Is there anything else you guys want your fans to know about? I mean, what you got coming up in 2018? Is there a wink, wink, nudge, nudge you can kind of give us a little heads up about?
You're in the office. Is there anything, ask Aaron if there's anything that we can leak out. Because there are a lot of things that I know we're talking about doing, but I don't know what we're allowed to say.
There's loads of stuff. We're in the studio currently. We've got like 2 weeks blocked out in the studio making more music for everybody. Just so we can, when people demand it, we've got songs ready to go, you know?
All right. Okay.
We've already made songs and we're going to do tons of shows. So just look out on the website and social media and we'll let you all know.
All right. That sounds awesome. So you guys want to keep an eye on them on the social medias, which is the Facebook, the Twitter, Instagram. You just look up Brown and Gray. You'll find them in one way, shape, or form. And then, of course, as I mentioned, there is that website, Brown and Gray Music, which "and" is spelled out. So it's brownandgraymusic.com. That's where you can catch their video. You can see their lineup of their shows. Some photographs are on there. You can get the links to the iTunes, the Spotify, and the Apple Music, where you can get that video or watch it right there and enjoy the sunshine with the red Mustang, which is absolutely gorgeous.
All right.
Woohoo! So if there's nothing else, guys, I want to thank you so much for taking time out of crazy schedule. I know you guys are busy, but I really appreciate it. And the invitation stands. If you ever are here in Northeast PA, please, please, please look me up. Come into the studio. Spend a little bit. We'd love to see you.
Oh, man, we're coming. We're doing it. We're coming. Thanks so much for having
me.
All right. And, you know, I'll reach out to your guys and just make sure that they have my contact information and let that happen. But hey, listen, I appreciate it. Good luck with everything. Safe in your travels, guys, when you're out and about. And we're going to be looking for that new music and those new videos. And if anything new is getting out there and getting launched, feel free to get back in touch with me. You're always welcome back on the show.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
We love Penn Peak Radio.
Yay! All right, thanks, guys. And I will talk to you soon, my friends. Take care. Brown and Gray, right here on Penn's Peak Radio.